It's about people, and it's about our planet. And SERVIR really tries to connect space to village by bringing space-based information to really meet the needs that people have around the world.
Southeast Asia is one of the most disaster-prone regions in the world.
And in Africa, you're finding countries are now experiencing more drought and famine.
Every day we have to issue a flood warning.
What's happening with climate change? What's happening to the glaciers in our water supply?
How do you link satellite images and data to environmental challenges? Floods, fires, the state of forest and land cover in the region.
We're not just providing a supply of tools and technologies. We're actually understanding the demand. What are the kinds of decisions that people need to be making that will affect the people in their country?
SERVIR really wanted to take advantage of NASA's constellation of satellites to address the many issues that they had in the region. And we used that unique vantage point of space to better understand and protect our home planet.
To understand SERVIR is to really understand all of the collaborations and partnerships that make those connections.
It's about building capacity, it's about growing new networks and expanding collaboration opportunities across the region with governments.
USAID brings to SERVIR its 70 offices around the world and long-standing relationships with governments in those countries. NASA really makes SERVIR possible because they bring this wealth of data and science capability to developing countries. And all of the innovations are possible because that data is free and open.
Before the JSON 2 came in operation, our modeling competition is entirely based on the surface measurement.
The success in this project is connecting satellite altimetry data to the Flood Forecasting and Warning Center and Institute for Water Modeling in Bangladesh. What this has done effectively is taken a 3 to 5 day warning and expanded it to an 8 day warning. The idea is that it will give people an extra 3 days to travel out of harm's way if a flood's coming.
What's happened recently, it was the earthquake in Nepal.
Our team literally was working around the clock in shifts. Our SERVIR hub at ECMOD was taking information and converting it into actionable information that they were sharing with government officials in Nepal.
It was quite amazing how our partners came together to bring these tools to help immediately after the disaster.
The purpose of GRESS is to estimate stream flow from precipitation data.
You need long-term data. Because of GRESS, we can be able to fill that data. If we are able to predict the amount of water in the rivers, we can do proper planning.
We give the government the information so that they are able to allocate the water.
The output from the GRESS model is not just used by the ministry. This information is able to reach the community.
We've worked in 4 regions in 37 countries. We've partnered with more than 94 different institutions.
It's a space agency partnering with a development agency. We're probably the 2 most different agencies in the federal government. And then partnering with really phenomenal regional institutions or SERVIR hubs around the globe.
We're hoping to be able to provide both policymakers at the government level and also people that are just making seasonal crop decisions about what to grow, trying to provide them with good information that they can use to make genuine decisions about what they're going to do next.
It doesn't do a whole lot of good for just one country or a few countries to be prepared when we all share this earth.
Knowledge is power, data is power. SERVIR Mekong has the ability to unlock some of that power for the masses.
We have to think about the whole chain from information to action, to collect the right data, to analyze it in ways that answer specific questions, to create tools that people can use easily, and then to help them with the uptake of those tools.
Even though we are very different, we look different, we even speak different languages, we all share the same passion and the same goal.
I actually feel very passionate about what we have put out for people to use. It feels great to be part of the solution.
As a little kid, I always looked up in the stars and said, what's it look like up there? But to actually have a view coming back and looking at us and seeing all the different dynamics between the oceans, the mountains, it's really fantastic.
That marriage between science and technology that brings NASA together, with USAID, together with our hubs from around the world, with the ultimate goal to serve society.
Nothing big that actually changes the world happens unless it starts with people and the relationships that they build and the trust that can come from that.